I have to correct key corrections for two questions. All right. First one is answer is only A, and third one is B, C, D. Cannot see this. Okay, first question answer is only A, and third question is B, C, D. All right. I'm going to discuss the question. Okay, coming to first question. One and option A and option C are somewhat easier. All of you are able to hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we all know if I take this in degrees, this is 0 degrees, radians it is 0. In degrees, this is 90 degrees, radians is 5 by 2. This is 180 degrees and 5. This is 270 degrees and 3 pi by 2. Pi by 2 is approximately 1.57. Pi is approximately 3.14. This is some 4.7 or something like that, roughly. So you can see 3 is in second quadrant and 4 is in third quadrant. 3 radians is less than 3.14 radians. And 4 radians is more than this and less than this. Okay, this is in second quadrant, this is in third quadrant. So obviously sine 3 is greater than 0 and sine 4 is less than 0. Based on that, I can tell sine 3 is greater than sine 4 because positive is obviously greater than negative. Coming to tan. Okay, can all of you hear me?
Yes, sir, we hear you.
Okay, so tan 3 is less than 0 and tan 4 is greater than 0. Why? Second quadrant tan is negative, third quadrant tan is positive. So tan 3 should be less than tan 4 because negative is less than positive. But they gave greater than, that's why C is not correct. If you want to attempt B or D, better to convert into degrees. 3 radians is around 3 into 57.2, approximately 151.71.6, okay, which can be written as 180 minus 8.4 degrees roughly. And 4 is 4 into 57.2, that is 228.8, okay, which is 270 minus, okay, or you can write 180 plus. How much is this? Around 48.8. So when I take sine 3, it is sine of this, which is sine 8.4 degrees. When I take sine 4, sine 180 plus is minus sine 48.8. But when I square it, sine square 8.4 and sine square 48.8 is around 9 degrees, is around 49 degrees. We know between 0 to 90, smaller angle, value of sine is smaller, right? So this is less than this. So based on that, sine square 3 is less than sine square 4. Here it is not about positive or negative. Both are positive because of square. Which is smaller, which is bigger. If I take cos 3 radians, based on this, it will be cos 8.4 with a minus. And if I take cos 4 radians, if I take cos 4 radian, cos 180 plus it is also minus, that is minus cos 48.8. If I don't take minus, sorry, some disturbance. So cos 3 is my, if you apply cos 180 minus theta, we got this and we got this. Without this minus, you can say cos smaller angle means greater is the value. We know between 0 degrees to 90 degrees, cos value decreases from 1 to 0, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So cos 8.4 value is obviously more than cos 48.8 degrees. But with, because of minus, this will be smaller. Without minus, this is greater, but with minus, this is smaller. So cos 3 is less than cos 4. Okay, but they might have given cos 3 greater than cos 4. That's why that is also not right. So that's why first question answer is only A. Is it okay, first question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, next we'll discuss second question just. All right. Anybody doubt about second question?
No, sir. No doubt, sir.
No.
No, sir.
Sir, second option, sir. I didn't.
Okay. No, sir. All right. All right. I'll discuss just on the screen itself. Main thing is in the second one, question itself is zero. How? Sin A plus B into sin A minus B. You can write sin square A minus sin square B. Better than that is you can write cos square B minus cos square A. Now when you divide with this cos square A, cos square B, you'll get 1 by cos square A minus 1 by cos square B, which is secant square A minus secant square B. You'll get secant square A minus secant square B plus secant square B minus secant square C plus secant square C minus secant square A. It is 0. So question is 0. How each option is 0? Coming to this, sin A minus B, I can write sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. So when I divide it cos A cos B, one time cos B will cancel, I'll get tan A. Another time cos A will cancel, I'll get tan B. Tan A minus tan B. If you open the sigma, you'll get tan A minus tan B, tan B minus tan C, tan C minus tan A. All will cancel, you will get 0. Coming to first option, there are three angles that are there here. 27 degrees is there, 32 degrees is there, 31 degrees is there. So if you take 27 plus 32 plus 31. What is sum of these three angles?
90 degrees.
So whenever A plus B plus C is 90 degrees, tan A tan B plus tan B tan C plus tan C tan A is 1. That is one of the question we have done. If not, tan of A plus B plus C formula denominator is 1 minus tan A tan B minus tan B tan C minus tan C tan A. Whenever A plus B plus C is 90, tan is undefined, means denominator is 0. So that's why this should be 0. So option 1 is a separate question, option 2 is a separate question. Question itself is a separate question, but all of them answer is 0, that's how they are equal. Otherwise, directly this is not equal. Is it okay, second question now?
Sir, once again, if you don't mind, first question, you said we should take that 27 plus 32 plus 31 as
90.
And apply tan, that's all.
Yes, yes. Okay. Then the denominator will be 0, tan A plus B plus C.
Okay.
Basically, A plus B plus C, if it is 90 degrees, tan A tan B plus tan B tan C plus tan C tan A equal to 1. We've done another question. So that is given as specific angle here. Okay, third question. Option A is not right because it should be minus 8 by 9. I just gave by mistake minus 4 by 9. Not so, okay, not a problem. We can change the key. A is not right. Please mute yourself. Whoever got unmuted.
Sir, option D once can you explain, sir? In the third one.
Yeah.
Option C also.
Okay, main thing in third one is sin p plus cos p is 1 by 3. That we have to manipulate this way. That's about some of the squares, the cubes, the power 4, power 5.
Sir, not able to see, sir.
Okay, if I square this, I will get sin square p plus cos square p plus 2 sin p cos p is equal to 1 by 9. If I send, this is 1, if I send that side, 2 sin p cos p is equal to 1 by 9 minus 1 is minus 8 by 9. Okay, so if I divide, I'll get sin p cos p equal to minus 4 by 9. Okay, this is related to option A. If you want cube, we have formula for a cube plus b cube as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. So if you want sin cube p plus cos cube p, it can be written as sin p plus cos p whole cube minus 3 sin p cos p into sin p plus cos p. A cube plus b cube is a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. Sin p plus cos p is 1 by 3. Sin p into cos p is minus 4 by 9. And sin p plus cos p is 1 by 3. And this is 27, this is 27 denominator. If I take, I'll get 1 plus 12. So 13 by 27. Okay, this is cube is there. If you want 4, we know sin square p plus cos square p is 1. We can square that. I can even multiply this with sin p plus cos p also, I'll get it. Okay. If I, for example, if I take a cube plus b cube into a plus b, to expand, you'll get a power 4 plus b power 4. You may get some extra terms, a cube b plus b cube a. You can take some a b common in that. You can do that way also. Or you can write sin square p plus cos square p equal to 1 and square it on both sides. We'll get sin power 4 p plus cos power 4 p plus 2 sin square p cos square p is equal to 1. Okay, so we want to find this, so you have to substitute this. So sin power 4p plus cos power 4p plus 2 into, what is sin p cos p?
Minus so, 4 by 9.
Whole square equal to 1. So sin power 4p plus cos power 4p is 1 minus 16, 32 by 81. That is some 49 by 81. If you want sin power 5 plus cos power 5, we can use binomial theorem and we can do it, but I want to manage without all that. Okay. So you take sin cube p plus cos cube p into sin square p plus cos square p. When you multiply, what will come? Okay, is my video clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Mrudula, you are facing any network issue? Alright, when I multiply these two, this into this is sine power 5p, this into this is sine cube p cos square p, this into this is cos cube p and sine square p, and this into this is cos power 5p. So this first and last together is sine power 5p plus cos power 5p. From this and this, I can take sine square p into cos square p common. I'll get sine p plus cos p. Okay. Now we want this, and we know this. Substitute all of this. What is sine cube p plus cos cube p? We got sometime back. I did not write that.
Another one doubt, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, sine square p plus cos square p, we can't write it as one.
No, sine square p into cos square p, we already found it is minus 4 by 9 whole square.
Sir, mistake. Sine square p into cos square p and not sine square p plus cos square p. There you wrote, no, sir.
Ah, this we can write one, but this value we have to find now.
Ah, yes, sir. Yes.
We already found in another option. I did not just erase yes, it. Yeah. So that, and this is our question now. Sin square p into cos square p is minus 4 by 9 whole square. Sin p plus cos p is some 1 by 3. Okay. So substitute this cube thing. Bring it this side. You will get sin power 5 plus cos power 5. So simple algebraic techniques you can manage. Is it all right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. One thing is, one should not be discouraged. All right. There will be some questions. You know, in the exam, you might have done, especially more than one of the questions, one option you don't see carefully means it is gone, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And some questions you have to get an idea, all right? So I told you many times, it is more important that you see after classes how many hours, first of all, are you attending classes seriously? And after classes, how many hours you are spending reading the notes, going through example problems and trying homework questions and all that, remembering the formulas, okay? Not that you don't study throughout the week, somehow you got marks in the exam, you should feel happy. Okay. Or throughout the week you study and you don't try get the marks, you are unhappy. No. Forget about the marks. Throughout the week, how is your effort? That is more important. That is going to carry you long the way. In one exam, suddenly you got idea for few questions. Okay. But if you don't work, it is not going to last. Okay. Passage one. First question. We had a similar question in the class where we gave 1 degree, 2 degree, all the way up to 180. But here I gave only even number. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how to do this one? Passage one, first question is. You can write... cos square 2 degree, cos square 4 degree, cos square 6 degree, all the way up to cos square 86 plus cos square 88 plus cos square 92. Cos square 92, I can write cos square 90 plus 2. Cos square 94, I can write 90 plus 4. Similarly, cos square 90 plus 6. Last 178, I can write 90 plus 78. And 180, I can write, 88. 90 plus 90. This cos square 90 plus 2, I can write sin square 2. This I can write sin square 4. This I can write sin square 6. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1, here also 1, here also 1, this also 1, this also 1. Like that you will get. How many 1? This is 2 into 1 degree, this 2 into 2, 2 into 3, 2 into 44, 2 into 43, 44, 45. So these are 45 terms, even numbers up to 90 are 45 terms. So you get 45 pair. So 45 into 1, it is 45. Is it okay? Passes one, first question.
Sir, 1 minute, please don't rub it, sir.
Okay.
Sir?
Yes, please tell.
Okay, this question first, if we take cos square 2 to cos square 88, we'll get 22. And again from cos square wait, 92 to
cos square 2 square. Plus cos square 88, you want to write it as 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you want to, okay, that is first 44 terms you want to combine. Okay, you will get some 22 pairs, right?
Again, after comparing the second 44 terms, we will be getting minus 22, sir.
No, everywhere square is there. Don't forget that.
Sir, here, sir, okay, so, don't mind, once again, can you explain, sir?
Okay, I'll explain. But Jyotirmay, all are square. There's no chance of getting minus anywhere. Is that okay?
Yes, sir. Actually, I got in the exam 45 only, sir. But okay. Here, when I tried it again, I'm getting it as minus
so,
1.
So now you are clear, right? Because of the square, all are plus.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Total number of terms as it is in the whole question is how much? 90 terms, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So last one is anyway 1. Cos 180 degrees is minus 1. Whole square will be 1. Leave that. Except the last one, rest of the... 1 minute. So how many? 2 into 1 or 2 into 90? So even numbers, sorry. Up to 180, half of that 90. So these are total 90 terms. Okay. So if you want to make them 45 pairs, you made first 22 pairs. The next ones are 23 pairs. You'll get 22 plus 23 is 45. It is not minus 22. Is your doubt clear, Jyotirmay?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. 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 This up to 90 degrees, I did not change at all. After 90, I'm changing it. So I'm not changing 88 as 90 minus 2. I want to save that another way. 92, I wrote 90 plus 2. 94, I wrote 90 plus 4. 96, I wrote 90 plus 6. 178, I wrote 90 plus 88. 180, I wrote 90 plus 90. So cos 90 plus 2 is sine 2. Maybe minus sine 2, but square is there. It will be plus sine square 2. Cos 90 plus theta is minus sine theta. Square it, sine. So this is sine square 2 degrees, sine square 4, sine square 6. This is sine square 88. And this is sine square 90. This plus this is 1. 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 So like that, we got 45 pairs. 45 into 1 is 45. Dheeraj, is it okay?
Yes, sir. That was my doubt. From where did you started converting?
From 92 onward. Okay.
Did not okay. Consider, did not see the square, sir. We got, I took care of minus 1.
Yeah. The squares, if you want to take care of minus, third, second question will give you that question.
Yes, right? Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, whereas in second question, what happens, I will not write 92 as 90 plus 2. Better is cos square 2 plus cos square 4 up to cos square 88 degrees as it is. Cos square 99 may be 0. Cos square 92, we will write 180 minus 88. Cos square 94, it is not square, cube, sorry. Cube everywhere. Cos cube 180 minus 88. Cos cube 180 minus 86. At the last 178, I can write 180 minus 2. And the cos 180 is minus 1. Whole cube. So what happens is, 178, I wrote 180 minus 2. It became minus cos 2. That and this will cancel. The previous to that, where you have 176, I can write 180 minus 4. That will become minus cos 4. That will get cancelled with this. Okay. So these 44 terms cancel with these 44. Cos square 90 is 0. Last term is minus 1. So answer is minus 1. Is it okay? Second one.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this passes one in the exam. Anybody kept both questions right in the exam?
I did, sir.
I kept right, sir.
Okay. G. Bharat, and who is the other one?
Jyotirmay.
Jyotirmay, yes. Anybody else kept both correct in the exam, passes one? All right. Okay. Numerical first question, it is a matter of getting idea. Okay. So if you could not do well in the exam, that attempt that exam, don't worry. Okay.
Yes, sir. One doubt, sir.
Yeah.
Sir.
Please, sir. Tell me.
Sir, means like technical doubt, sir. I am not able to see your screen properly, sir. Not able to see your screen properly, sir.
Are you able to see now?
1 minute, sir. You shared screen. I'll check it, sir. 1 minute. Yes, sir. Now little clearer, sir. Better than before.
Okay. Actually, more than the board, feed will be always clear. There will not be any issue generally.
Yes, sir. I am also talking about the board only. Sir.
Okay. Yes, you are talking to the board?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Board means you have to see your network, of course.
Okay.
In first question, you have to get an idea that finally in the question that I asked, D is missing. There is no D, right?
Yes, sir.
So how to eliminate D? Send cos D to the other side, sin D to the other side, square and add. Okay, let us see what happens. Okay, cos D, if I send that side, minus cos D will come equal to cos A plus cos B plus cos C. And minus sin D is equal to sin A plus sin B plus sin C. If I square and add, I'll get minus cos D whole square plus minus sin D whole square equal to cos A plus cos B plus cos C whole square plus sin A plus sin B plus sin C whole square. Cos square D plus sin square D, minus will take care and bear by square. Cos square D plus sin square D is 1. If I expand this a plus d plus c whole square formula, a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab and all that, you will get cos square a plus cos square b plus cos square c plus 2 cos a cos b plus 2 cos b cos c plus 2 cos c cos a. The next one will come sin square a plus sin square b plus sin square c plus 2 sin a sin b, 2 sin b sin c, 2 sin c sin a. Now, when I add, cos square a plus sin square a is 1, cos square b plus sin square c is 1, cos square c plus sin square c is 1. If I take 2 common, cos a cos b plus sin a sin b is cos a minus c. Cos b cos c plus sin b sin c is cos b minus c. Cos c cos a plus sin b sin a is cos c minus c. So, this is 3, bring this side, we'll get 1 minus 3 equal to 2 times our question. This is a minus 2 by 2, it is minus 1. So it is a matter of getting idea that D is not asked in the question, so it eliminate D. So let us isolate D in one side, square and add, D is gone, and A plus B plus C was the formula, and then compound angles formula.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, here 1 plus 1 plus 1, how did you get, sir?
Cos square A plus sin square A.
Oh, okay, sir.
Cos square B plus sin square B, and cos square C plus sin square C. Thank you. All right. Second question. We know we don't know value of 10, 21 degrees and all. Even if you don't know still how to manage, this 261, you can write 270 minus 9. This 69, you can write 90 minus 21. And this 81, you can write 90 minus 9. And this 225, you can write 180 plus 45. Okay. So if you write 225 is 180 plus 45, tan 45 will get 1. 81, if you write 90 minus 9, cot 9 will become tan 9. And cot 69, if you write 90 minus 21, it will become tan 21. And 261, when you wrote 270 minus 9, cot will become tan. You will get tan 9 plus tan 21. So it is tan A plus tan B, 1 minus tan A, tan B, reciprocal of that. If you use tan A plus B formula, it will become tan 30. Reciprocal of tan 30 is root 3. Root 3 whole square is 3.
Sir, we should... Sir, keep that screen thing again, sir, once. Put on the screen.
Undo. Okay.
Yes.
Is everybody clear about second question?
Clear, sir. Clear.
Okay, third question is actually very, very simple. You don't use any compound angles and all that. Simply write every cot as 1 by 10. This cot A, you write 1 by 10 A. This you write 1 by 10 B, take LCM, you will get 10 A, 10 B. Then simplified. This you write 1 by 10 A, 1 by 10, take LCM, take minus common, they will get cancelled again, you will get minus 10 A, 10 B. So, writing cot as 1 by 10, taking LCM and cancelling, the first ratio will become 10 A, 10 B. Second ratio will become minus tan A tan B. They will cancel out. You will get 0.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, there it is given that cot A is not equal to cot B. Why it is given that?
Actually, it should be given cot A equal to not minus cot B. Why it is given is basically if denominator is 0, it is not defined, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the reason they gave cot A, cot B not equal to 1 is so that this denominator is not 0. It is defined.
Here yes, they sir, should have given... that I understand, but yes, sir, that one only, man.
Yeah. Here they should have given cot A not equal to minus cot B. Their minus is not printed. That doesn't affect the solution. Yes. Just for the question to be validity. The validity of the question for that only.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, once again, once you can explain third one, sir.
Tan A plus tan B, this denominator cot A, you write 1 by tan A. This you write 1 by tan B. You'll get tan A plus tan B. If you take LCM, you'll get tan B plus tan A by tan A into tan B. This and this will cancel. This will go up. You'll get tan A into tan B. Next, 1 minus tan A tan B. The cot A, cot B here, I will write tan A and tan B. So, 1 minus tan A, tan B. If I take LCM, I will get tan A, tan B minus 1 by tan A, tan B. This and this are more or less same, cancel, but you will get a minus common. This will go up. You will get minus tan A, tan B. This plus this will cancel. You will get 0. Is that okay?
Okay.
Okay, fourth question is very easy. You can write cosecant as 1 by sine. You'll get a quadratic equation. You'll get sine theta equal to 1. Sine theta is 1. Cosecant theta is also 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay. Okay, so exam paper, all doubts are done, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so only two questions are key change. First one is A and third one is B, C, D. That is a key change. Otherwise, everything is fine. But next track also, I think everything is good. But if you have doubts, you can ask in third class. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, in the class, the other day, we completed. Yes, please.
Sir, yesterday, that means day before yesterday, you gave that last you gave how to find when angle is theta is equal to 18 degree.
Yeah.
So in that I am having one doubt, sir. So
did I write the full solution of sine 18
sir,
degrees?
Sir, you said yes, sir. Yes,
okay,
sir.
So sine 18 degrees I derived it. Okay, now I asked a question, why extra answers are coming. Is that your doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you want to answer or you want to ask?
No, sir. I want to ask that only.
Yeah, okay. So basically, when I took theta equal to 18 degrees and phi theta is 90 degrees and sine phi, I wrote, of course, 3 theta equal to 90 minus 2 theta. I might have applied cos 3 theta is equal to cos 90 minus 2 theta. Okay, I got something. But I think finally I got cos theta equal to 0, sine theta equal to root pi minus 1 by 4, sine theta equal to minus 1. Minus root 5 by 4. This is okay. Why these answers also came here is that this means theta equal to 90. This means actually theta equal to minus 54 degrees. We'll discuss later. Okay, about why it is minus 54. But now, why 90 degrees also satisfying? You take theta equal to 90, then what is phi theta? 450. Phi theta is 450. You can write 3 theta equal to 450 minus 2 theta. I apply cos. When I apply cos, what will come here, same thing will come there. Why? The only difference is here 90, here 450. An extra 360. By adding 360, will any trigonometric value will change?
No, sir.
Okay. So if you apply cos on both sides here or cos on both sides here, there is no difference because it is 3 theta equal to 360 plus 90 minus 2 theta. That means whenever A equal to B, you can no doubt say cos A equal to cos B. From here to here it is correct. But from here to here, is it correct? No, there are other options.
No,
for example,
sir.
If somebody tells you A equal to 360 plus B, then also cos A equal to cos B.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
And somebody
yes,
tells sir. You A equal to minus 360 plus B, then also cos A equal to cos B. So whenever you take a question and you apply cos on both sides, don't think you are only solving that question. You are solving some other questions also by adding 360, by adding 720, by adding 1080. You are getting all those solutions. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to minus 54, let us see what happens. When theta is minus 54, phi theta is minus 250 plus 270 degrees. That is minus 360 plus 90. If you send 2 theta that side, 3 theta equal to minus 360. Plus 90 minus 2 theta. So this and this are only differences. Subtract the 360. When you apply cos, the 360 will be gone. Again, you get same result. That's why even that is also included. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So to say simply, it is not only 90. You can take 90 plus 360 or 90 minus 360. It is not going to change. Right? So what is 90 plus 360? 450. And what is 450 by 5? 90 degrees. That's why cos 90 came 0. What is 90 minus 360? Minus 270. What is minus 270 by 5? Minus 54. That's why we have also got sine minus 54 value also. Is it clear? Okay. Okay, we've done only sine 18. We have to just do a few more angles. In your class notes, we can continue. Cos 36, did I have I completed in the class or no? The last class.
Sir, what's that? Yes. Once again, can you repeat?
Sine 18 degrees I derived. After that, did I find cos 36 degrees in the class?
No,
cos,
sir.
No,
sir.
Cos 36 degrees, you can write cos 2 times 18 degrees. Cos 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sine square theta. You will get 1 minus 2 sine square 18 degrees. Okay. So 1 minus 2 into sine 18 degrees is root 5 minus 1 by 4 whole square. Expand it, you will get 5 plus 1 minus 2 root 5 by 16. That is 6. I can take 2 common and cancel, of course. 4, this is 6 means 3 minus root 5 by 4. That is 4 minus 3 plus root 5 by 4, which is root 5 plus 1 by 4. Okay, so before this you can write, first of all, cos 36 degrees is equal to root 5 plus 1 by 4. Further, this is a proof. Cos 36 degrees is root 5 plus 1 by 4. We are deriving using sine 18 degrees. Okay, if somebody wants sine 36 or cos 54 degrees, which is same as sine 36, you can write square root of 1 minus cos square 36. Just now we done cos 36, you will get root 5 plus 1 by 4 whole square. This is 16. If I take LCM, 16 minus 5 plus 1 plus 2 root 5 by 16. Please mute yourself, whoever got unmuted. This is 10 minus 2 root 5 by 16. That is square root of 10 minus 2 root 5 by 4. Okay, similarly, if you want sine 54, we already done. Sine 72, which is cos 18 degrees, is square root of 1 minus sine square 18 degrees. And if you simplify that, you'll get root over, you know, sine 18, you can substitute it. Root 1 minus root 5 minus 1 by 4 whole square. I'm not going to write in between steps, so directly it will become root over 10 plus 2 root 5 by 4. This is 10 minus 2 root 5 and this is 10 plus 2 root 5. Yes, please tell me.
Sir, what is the syllabus for coming GMS exam, sir, maths?
Compound angles and multiple and submultiple angles.
Okay, sir.
Sir, again compound angles will come, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
But I don't know when is the exam, because coming Sunday is August 15th. So whether they would like to keep on Monday, I don't know. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Definitely exam will be there, but whether it is Saturday or Monday, or they may say anyway online only, write at home what is there to celebrate August 15th, we can keep also, right?
Sir, it's yeah. Like on August 15th, Rakhi is also.
Oh, both came on the same day.
Yes, okay. Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, I'm going to erase this whole thing. Anybody needs more time?
Just 1 minute.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Completed. Thank you, sir.
Okay, everybody has to remember these values, because whenever you want, you cannot derive it because they're quite lengthy to, I mean, takes time to derive it. Okay, so you have to remember sine 18 degrees is same as cos 72 degrees, which is root 5 minus 1 by 4. Sine 36, which is same as cos 54 degrees, is root over 10 minus 2 root 5 by 4. Sine 54 degrees, which is same as cos 56 degrees, is root 5 plus 1 by 4. And sine 72 degrees, which is same as cos 18 degrees, is root over 10 plus 2 root 5 by 4. Okay, first of all, you should remember the formula and you should not get confused. Let us look at sine values. You know, as angle increases, sine values should increase. So at least 18 and 54, among them, you know, 18 is smaller, 54 is greater. So that's why this is root 5 minus 1 by 4, whereas this one is root 5 plus 1 by 4. Sine 36 and sine 72, they are under square root. There is no way to simplify it. You cannot simplify this third and write without square root. You want to write an answer, you cannot write. Sine 36 is root over 10 minus 2 root 5 by 4. Sine 72 is root over 10 plus 2 root 5 by 4. Minus here, plus here. Because this is smaller, this is bigger. Similarly, minus here, plus here. Because this is smaller, this is bigger. And the sine 18 and sine 54 are nice without much square root. Whereas these two are under the square root. And if you remember all the sine values, automatically you will remember all the cos values. Because 90 minus theta formula can be used. So these eight values are four values everybody has to remember. Some which are very simple to derive, even if you forget, you can derive it, but otherwise you cannot do. Lengthy ones will not be able to do. Okay, everybody wrote these four values?
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
Okay. So, remember the derivation. Sir. At the same time, you should remember the values also, because whenever you forget, you cannot derive instantly. Okay, what I'm going to tell, I'm not saying it is a formula, but it is a question. I'll give some idea. I'll continue tomorrow. Let us take root over 1 plus sine 2a by square root of 1 minus sine 2a. This 1 I can write, please mute yourself, whoever got unmuted. This is sine square a plus cos square a plus 2 sine a cos a. And this is sine square a plus cos square a minus 2 sine a cos a. So I am writing sine 2a as 2 sine a cos a, 1 as sine square a plus cos square a. This is a perfect square. I can write it as sine a plus cos a whole square. This is also a perfect square. I can write sine a minus cos a whole square. So we already quite thoroughly discussed root x square. We cannot write x. We have to write mod x. So this is mod sine a plus cos a. This is mod sine a minus cos a. We know mod x definition, that it is x if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus x if x is less than 0. We thoroughly discussed about it. So when I remove the mod, will I get this inner expression as it is, or will I get negative? Will I get this expression as it is or negative? Based on that, answer here can be 2 sine a or 2 cos a, minus 2 sine a or minus 2 cos a. In which interval what will come? Okay. That you think about it, what is the interval under which answer is 2 sin a, what is the interval under which 2 cos a. Tomorrow we'll discuss. You don't have to write, just I gave you idea. So if you want to write one or two lines, it's okay, but I want you to think about it, and if you got some idea, tell me tomorrow. All right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So
yes, sir.
Multiple submultiple angles, mains material, you can start trying even numbers. At least 15 questions you can try by tomorrow, even numbers. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Good morning, students. I'm here.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Can you all hear me well?
Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I don't have the headset on right now, but if you can hear me well, that's fine. Probably I don't need